Hello, you what's his faces. Welcome back to a new video. Tygon here, and today I have a video. Of course you read the title, so you know what it is about. And I guess by reading the title, you know that I have chosen to play flat. Now, I will do like little series, especially my gyroscope series, where I'm going to hold my device. But just for 90% of my gameplay, it's going to be me playing flat. So I'm going to go ahead and get into me playing flat, because many people, I guess since I put that poll up, have actually asked me to teach how to play flat. And without further ado, let's begin. Now, the first thing I do want to go ahead and address is the fact that people say playing flat is bad for your back. Now, technically, you're right. But at the same time, so is literally 90% of the stuff you do at a desk. Like, the position I'm sitting in right now is the exact same thing or position I'd be in if I were to go ahead and, I don't know, start writing a paper or something like that. You know what I mean? So, if you're working at an office job, literally anything, you're going to be in this position, right? And what people do to, you know, compensate for this, of course, is make sure you stretch, work out, just do all those other things. So, yes, technically, it is not good for your back. But in general, 90% of the way, I guess the modern era lives their lives, is not necessarily good. Like, this is how I am in school, like, for pretty much 6 hours, and maybe every hour or so, we go ahead and switch periods. But this is pretty much how I am, the exact same position I am in school. So you really shouldn't feel any different than you would feel if you're working at an office or school. Now, the other thing is, people also say it's bad for your back, but 90% of people that I see go ahead and play, when they hold a phone, they hold it like this. They're literally holding their phone like this 90% of the time, and they're looking down anyway. So I'm like, is it really that much of a difference? And I feel no difference. So I guess I would say 90% of people play holding like this. I personally, when I play holding, my elbows are directly up on top of my desk. That actually feels more stable for me. But 90% of the people that I see go ahead and play holding, hold looking like this. So no, I mean, it's technically it is, but at the same time, 90% of everything you do, it is bad. So like, just make sure to go ahead, stretch, work out, just do the proper things you're supposed to do to make sure you don't get back issues. It's pretty much the same thing as almost any sport. Anything you do, you want to go ahead and make sure you don't overdo it. Take frequent breaks and do that. But now that we've got that out of the way, let's go ahead and get into it. So there's two ways you can play it. Of course, you guys have heard me go ahead and talk about my made up way that I created. I think I call it Dragon Wing Claw. Yeah, and I call it that for a reason, as you guys know, and as I said in that previous video. And I call it that because, you see, it's like a dragon wing and it's free. Now, do not go ahead and try that when you're first going and learning flat, because it's going to mess you up. And it's going to mess you up because there's no stability. So if you're going ahead and you're playing flat and you're going ahead and trying to do this, it's going to be really hard. I can do it because I've been playing for like, I think I've started using this for about a month and a half now. And yeah, so it's easy and I don't feel, it doesn't feel as crazy. But if you're just starting out, you're going to miss a lot of your shots. But the reason why I do this in the first place, it is because it does allow for my tracking to be better. And me not to run out of room, pretty much like a tablet player. That's why I play like this. But when you first get into it, you want to have your hands hugging the device for two reasons. One, the first reason is it essentially makes it easier to go ahead and get started. The other reason is because it allows you to, you know, hit shots easier with sniper. So even though I play like this, if I'm going to go ahead and start sniping, where I'm quick scoping, I'm going to go ahead and hug the device more so with my hand. Or if I want to make my shots more accurate, I'm going to hug the device with my hand. Funnily enough, I can track easier like this, but when I'm like this, it's going to make my shots more accurate. It's going to make them more stable. So that's why I have them like this. And the number one, well, I would say one of the main issues with playing flat is simply the fact that you're going to have to try to get back in the same position every time. So the one thing you want to also keep in mind is have a base. I always recommend the hand that is not your aiming hand, which is always going to be your left hand, because usually the aim, most people, I think 99.9% of people that aim on mobile aim with this side. You don't have this as a base. You don't want this to move, if at all. So you can use any way you want. Maybe clamp your hand to the bottom of the desk or like this, and go ahead and hold it like this. If you're doing this, then your hand is pretty much a base. You don't want this to move because this is your base, and this allows you to keep this aim steady, and it allows you to recreate how you went in the first place. Don't do this. This is free floating. I've done it before, and it's kind of good, but it's bad because it's not the best way to play, because what you want to have is consistency. And while this is good and allows you to be free even with your aim, your movement, it's not good because it's hard to keep your consistency while playing like this. You want to have a base because it also makes your movement better. Like when I try to play like this, it feels like I'm like a puppet master or something. There's no control. It's really, really hard. And you're gonna wanna be consistent, especially when you're learning something new. So make sure you have it clamped down. That's what you're gonna wanna go ahead and do, as you guys see me. So this is the base, and this you're gonna wanna do like this. Now, if you see my thumb, when you first get on, you're gonna wanna pretty much have it look like a windshield wiper almost, and then lift up a little bit. That's how you're gonna wanna go ahead and play it and get used to it. Now, just remember, put your hand like down like that every time and do it. Now, another thing I will get into is if you do wanna end up, I guess, after playing for a while and you're getting better at playing flat, you wanna try playing like this. This is definitely gonna be hard if you're moving around and you're going to different places. For example, like let's say I'm sitting on one table and then I go to another table. Playing like this, it is way better and way easier to do if you are at a consistent height, because depending on how my table and chair is set up, my hand is going to be in a different position. It's gonna be way harder to play like this. So that is another reason why you don't really wanna play like this Dragon Wing Claw I have, unless you're like really stable, which since I'm a content creator, 9% of the time I'm gonna be really stable. And also I pretty much can do it on any surface just because of how long I've played it like this, but it's gonna be really hard. So as I said before, you're gonna wanna start out like this. But once you have that in mind, then you're gonna get into it. Now, the first thing I will say is, you may wanna lower your sensitivity. When I first went ahead and started playing flat, I lowered my sensitivity, and then I ended up changing it back to what I had just because I got used to it. But the thing about playing flat is it gives you so much more space. If I'm holding my device, my hands are kind of constricted, as you guys can see. I don't have that much space. Not to mention my hands is really hugging the device. Even if I was playing four fingers, yes, I do have way more space, but at the end of the day, it still is really constricted. When I'm playing flat, I don't have any constraints on my hands really at all. I can move it completely free. And that's gonna tempt you to do that. Don't do that, because you wanna have like a little space that you roll around. You don't wanna, even though it does allow you to do that, don't do it too much, because as I said, you wanna be able to have consistency. You wanna be able to do it every time. You wanna be able to get on and have that consistency. That's the hardest part about learning to play flat. But once you have that, you should be relatively fine with playing flat. And you don't want to change your HUD at all, really, because that's going to be another thing on top of what you're already learning. You're pretty much learning a new sensitivity and a new way to place your fingers, and a second, I guess, new sensitivity, because your fingers are in a completely different position too. So it's going to be feeling really weird when you first get into it, but you will get the hang of it. So don't change your HUD, because there's really no reason to, because you can pretty much access any button you need to. Now, of course, move it slightly closer if your fingers need to go ahead and get there, but you don't need to change HUD. Now, people were also asking me the best HUD, like the best four finger claw HUD for flat. Just use the HUD you're already using, because when you're playing flat, as I just said, you can reach pretty much anything because you're not gripping the device, and it's really less strain on your hands overall. So I can literally, if I wanted to, almost sit back and play like this. Now, of course, when you get into a game, you lean over, but my hands are pretty much free. There's no strain on my hands whatsoever. People are like, how do you play eight fingers like this? It doesn't hurt at all to play. Like, not to mention the fact, if you guys start playing flat, you'll realize I can see really easily. In fact, I block more of my view when I play four finger than I play when I play eight finger flat, which people don't believe, but it actually is true. I can see everything. There's nothing that's out of my view simply because I can see it. Now, once you have a consistent base you can work with, go ahead and play the most intense game mode that you can find. For example, Shipment Hardpoint would be a good way to go ahead and do that. Or just playing, I don't recommend playing ranked if you don't want to mess up your ranked stuff, but just play anything that is going to be really hard. Not necessarily hard, but action-packed, where you're constantly going to have to be, reacting. So it can get ingrained in your brain. But once you have that done, just go ahead, practice that. And I mean, at the end of the day, that's how you get it. So this is essentially the video. Just go ahead, practice, and then make sure not to change your HUD. And remember to hug your device like this. Now, the last thing I will say for those who stayed is if you your back might, let's say, I don't know, you have super good posture while you write, right? Some people do. I have terrible posture while I write. And if you still want to play flat, you can actually go ahead, get a book and place it on the table and then use the like the back hard part of the book to then go ahead and place your device on. That's one way. The other way, it's a bit more expensive, is you can go ahead and buy yourself a PC cooler. And a PC cooler is going to have a nice slant where you can essentially easily look down and it's a bit higher for your hands. So that's what I used to play on. I decided just to play completely flat. Now, of course, if you go ahead and play on a PC cooler, it's kind of less mobile. So it's really up to you. But yeah, that's pretty much how you play flat. Now, the other way is, and this is another person that plays flat, they actually use their finger to aim and then they have a button and they hit their, they use their thumb to go ahead and shoot and kind of track a little bit. But pretty much they just use their index finger to go ahead and turn around. Now, this actually isn't that bad of a way to play. I actually have a video on it. I'll link it up there, but I think it was called Aiming with My Index Finger. And yes, you pretty much just aim with your index finger and then you go ahead and play. But yeah, playing flat, I can play any amount of fingers I want. I can play 2 fingers, I can play 4 fingers, I can play 8 fingers, I can play 10. But yeah, that's pretty much the video. Hope you guys enjoyed and you go ahead and take this with you. Okay? Yeah, I'll go ahead and I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.